Go ahead.
My bad.
All right, you can look.
We got London on the track.
Whoa.
On the
track, yeah, man, T.I.P. To the max with it. Rex.
I count 6 shots.
Hey, y'all. Welcome back to my channel. So today we are going to be using Nair face cream to do my roommate's brows. Y'all, that's Nair. You used to be gone, now you there. Nair. For real. But it's face cream, so it's safe, I promise. It's nothing crazy. I've been doing it for 2-3 years and had no problems yet. I don't have any brows, y'all. Y'all know I don't got no brows. Like, I got a little bit. I don't got much. So things you'll need, you're going to need like an old makeup brush. And basically just some witch hazel and some cotton pads. That's it, y'all. It's real cheap. And I think this Nair face cream is about $5-6 in the store. So nothing too crazy, you know, ball on a budget. And it lasts forever. So first, I am going to be outlining the brows. As like, if you do your makeup, if you know how to do brows, you can do your eyebrows. Like, just stay on the perimeter, please. Just stay on the perimeter. Don't try to go in. Don't try to take them in at all. Like, I know the eyebrow ladies, when you go get your brows done, they try to take them in. And they do good because they know how to do that stuff. But, like, don't try to take them in on yourself. Just do the perimeter. I promise it will turn out okay. Like, it's going to be cute still. So, I know this is old news to a lot of people, but I've been doing this for, like, 3 years now. So, I just wanted to share, just in case somebody not hip to game, somebody might not know. So what I did was just outline her brows, and like, I wanted to keep them. I like her brows, they're so full. And she told me that usually, like, when she go get them done, like, some people take them in too much. And she didn't tell me this beforehand or anything. I just already, like, I already knew if I did her brows, they were gonna come out good. Like, just because the Nair, like, it picks up all the hair, pretty much, like, if you was to get them waxed. So it picks up everything around the perimeter, and it basically just cleans them up. But her brows have been not done in so long, it did great. So first, we're gonna wipe it off. Oh my gosh. So when this comes off, it looks like, I should have showed y'all on the camera, but it looks like a perm, a pure perm. Like, it just looked like everything's like crazy.
I know, I'm not.
So use your little spoolie up the brows or whatever. And I put some witch hazel on the cotton pads, just to add a little cooling, like, just to wipe it off. Like, you need some type of lubricant on there, some water or something, anything. I used to use a warm rag and water. So after I wipe that off, you need to go both ways when you wipe it off as well. I know I didn't show it on the first brow, but I'll show it here. So you need to wipe both ways, just to, that's just like an extra scrub, because if you wipe the same way, you're not gonna get everything off. Then you use the spoolie, get any finishing touches. And if you need to use the eyebrow razor, definitely do that. Definitely. Sometimes the Nair won't pick up the tougher hairs. I have that problem sometimes, but barely. I ain't got no brows.
Okay.
All right,
you can look. I can look.
Yeah.
Oh.
Yeah.
Oh,
yeah. Girl, get into this cleanness. Get into this. Get into this. New. Y'all, I just really want to thank my roommate. Can we just take a moment of silence to her? Because, girl, you didn't trust in me with your brows. Your brows, your eyebrows. Like, them things is noticeable. Like, you trusted me. And look. Okay. I know that's right. Ain't never ever wrong. She loved it, y'all. I'm shook. She shook. We all shook. Alright guys, I really hope you guys enjoyed this video. Thank you so much for watching. Bye. Hey, no use to you ringing my line. Stop wasting my time.